So hello, in this video I am going to discuss again some of the questions from the main group chemistry from the previous CSIR NEET question. Now let's see the first question, that is this question comes in recent CSIR NEET exam for 4 marks. Now the statements are given and we have to choose the correct option regarding the statement. The first statement is arsenic pentachloride is thermally less stable than PCl5 and size of arsenium is more than that of P. So size of arsenic is greater than P because as we go down the group size increases. So this is a correct statement, means statement 1, statement 2 is correct, that is statement 2 is correct statement. Now regarding the first statement, arsenic pentachloride is thermally less stable than PCl5, which is also correct. So why that is a correct statement? There actually thermal stability should goes on increasing like this, means arsenic chloride will be more stable than this and arsenic phosphorus antimony this antimony. So actually PCl5 and arsenic antimony are the stable, while that arsenic chloride, arsenic pentachloride is less stable. Thus reason for that is, this is a due to poor shielding of d orbital, that is 3d orbital specially. You know that order of shielding is p is s is greater than p, p is greater than d is greater than f. So that is the poor shielding of 3d orbital on 4s. Due to what happen, energy of 4s will be decreased, so it will doesn't take part in hybridization. So therefore that in case of TBP geometry of arsenic pentachloride, sp3d is taking place, so s will not contribute from the 4s. So therefore arsenic pentachloride is thermally less stable while arsenic trichloride is stable. So statement 1 and 2 are correct, but statement 1 and 2 are true, but 2 is correct explanation of 1, that is not, because the reason is a shielding effect. Statement 1 and 2 are true, but 2 is not correct explanation 1, which is correct. Statement 1 and 1 is true, second is false. No, because both our statements are true. Both 1 and 2 are false, which is wrong. So correct answer will be second. There are no relation between there in case of size and thermal stability of this. Next question is consider statement regarding that C8 potassium graphite. It is a paramagnetic, it has eclipse structure and it is electrical conductive greater than C. So this is C8 nothing but intercalation, that is graphite. When this react with potassium, intercalation compound form. Means intercalation compound nothing but they are compounds of graphite in which the at two layers of graphite sandwich compounds, means that metal will, so sandwich graphite sandwich compound, that is this is a one layer of graphite, this is one layer of graphite, so the alkali metal will be act as host between these two graphite. So intercalation nothing but sandwich, that host will act as sandwich between two layer of graphite. So when treated with graphite, it will act as a reducing agent, it will give potassium positive and one electron. So that one electron correspond to the electrical conductivity and magnetism. So first, that is it is a paramagnetic, yes it is a paramagnet, which is presence of that unpaired electron which is given by the potassium. The third statement is its electric conductivity greater than graphite, because when graphite reactive with potassium, that potassium will give unpaired electron, means generally alkali metal and act as a reducing agent, so it will reduce the graphite, so that contain unpaired electron which cause the magnetism in graphite. So electric conductivity is greater than graphite and it has a eclipse structure, means two layer will along, this is one layer and this is one layer, so this will be formed like this. So the correct answer will be all three statements are correct. So correct answer is a fourth statement. This is a reaction of BCl3 with ammonium chloride gives product A, which upon reduction by NaBH4 gives product B. Product B upon reacting with HCl affords compound C, which is we have to predict this compound C structure, means what is the molecular formula for. So this is nothing but Borazin reaction. I have discussed in this previous video. I will give in I video here over there. So go check it out, that first part of P block. There I discuss the reaction of same Borazin. So what happened, did ammonium chloride BCl3 react with ammonium chloride to give trichloroborazin? That is nothing but B3N3H3Cl3, which on reduction with NaBH4 gives your borazin, that is B3N3H6. So what happened in next step, it react with HCl. So your boron compound, like that is a borazin. So the borazin will be look like this, NH2NH2, 1H1 chlorine, 1H1 chlorine, 1H1 chlorine. So the more, that is a chlorination step happen. That is a chlorine, it will add a nucleophile as well as a electrophile, that is H plus and Cl minus is added to here. Then H will attack our borin, boron. In previous video I have said that boron is electron deficient, so nucleophile attack will be act on that boron and nitrogen act as a electrophile, electrophile attack. So this will be the correct statement, means correct option will be B3, 3 chlorine will be there, B3, N3 and H9. So correct option will be option A. Next is from June 2015, four marks. Water play different role, four reactions were given. So we have to choose the correct role of water in each reaction. So first reaction you have seen what is happening in, calcium is oxidized to calcium 2, means water has act as oxidation reagent, means oxidant. And here what is happening next option, that is chlorine, what happened in oxide, water is having amphoteric nature, means it can act as acid, it can act as a base. So in this what happened, it will act as acid because chlorine minus, so it will extract the proton, so it will like act as a acid. So this is a so in second reaction it will act as a acid. So for third reaction, so this is a metal, so alkali metal, generally metals are the Lewis acid, so water in this case act as a base because Mg2+ is a Lewis acid. Fourth reaction what happened, that fluorine is in zero oxidation state, it converted into -1, so in this case water will act as a reducing agent, that is reductant. So correct option will be option number A. We have to look in from first and fourth reaction, you can see that calcium is converted to calcium 2+, so obviously water is act as a oxidation, so it will oxidize calcium. And in fourth, for fluorine the oxidation state change by -1, so it will act as reductant. So you have two options are there, but the problems create here, there you have to look the amphoteric nature of water, so in which case here water will act as acid or water will act as a base. So Lewis acid generally are metals, so Lewis acid, they are electron acceptor, so that will accept the electron, so this will, the water will act as a base. So next question is, oxo acid has phosphorus, having phosphorus atom in +4, +3, +4 oxidation state, mean from the following oxo acid has phosphorus, which of the particular compound contain that 3 phosphorus having +4 state, 1 phosphorus in this having +4, one having +3, another for +4. So means total 3 phosphorus have total oxidation state of +1. So we have to look at each structure and see which of the show 3 phosphorus give total +1, +11 oxidation state. If you take compound number 3, it will be, let's see, oxygen has a -2 charge, so it will be -16. Hydrogen give +5, so what will be, phosphorus will give 16 - 5 + 1, so your option will be C. If you compare with other option, let's take H5P3O10, here minus 20, each oxygen gives minus 2, minus oxidation state of oxygen is minus 2, so 10 into 2, 20, here plus 5, so 20 minus 5, 15. In this case, H5P3O7 means this is a minus 14, this is plus 5, 14 minus 5, I think 9, so this will be plus 9. Here in case of H5P3O9, 18 minus 18 plus 5, this is 13. So only C option will give 3 phosphorus total content plus 11 char. So correct option will be C. Now let's see next question. Compound that will behave as an acid in sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid as a among the strong acid, if we compare nitric acid and HCl, but perchloric acid is stronger than HClO4 because perchloric acid conjugate base is stronger than conjugate base of sulfuric acid. So perchloric acid will be stronger acid than sulfuric acid. So therefore, when reaction of perchloric acid will be reacted with, when perchloric acid reacted with sulfuric acid, so it will act as an acid, and since perchloric acid is stronger acid than sulfuric acid, so sulfuric acid will act as a base, so it will extract the proton from that sulfuric acid. So correct option will be C. Now next is order of correct electronegativity, decreasing order of correct electronegativity following the path. So four elements are given: calcium, aluminium, arsenic and sulfur. So for this you can see, this is a general periodic table. I can see here main group element generally lies on right hand side. This is a P block, here right S block, this is a, so calcium position will be here and aluminium position will be look here, and aluminium in same line, same period sulfur will lie, and here that arsenic will be. From here is as we go from left to right, electronegativity increases. So last option will be calcium, means lowest electronegative will be calcium. So next will be what? Aluminium, and from will be arsenic, and then sulfur. So correct option will be chlorine. Sulfur have highest electronegativity as compared to arsenic. Arsenic have higher electronegativity as compared to aluminium, and last will be chlorine. So this is going left to right. So first will be this, second will be this, third will be this, and fourth will be this. So correct option will be sulfur will be high. That is option number B. Now let's see next. Xenon forms several fluorides and oxofluoride which exhibit acidic order, acidic behavior. Correct the correct order of decreasing Lewis acidity, means I have to look at the acidity order. So acidity order means which is the more acidic, decreasing order we have to show. For xenon fluorides and oxofluorides, acidity increases, number of fluorine atom increases, acidity also increases. Along with that, oxidation state of xenon also matter. So more number of fluorine atom correspond to more number of acidity. So obviously xenon with highest number of fluorine in this case, that is 6, so it will be more acidic in there. After that we have to look, 5 fluorine atoms will be there in compound. No, then next will be another is xenon oxofluoride. After that your xenon tetrafluoride will come. After that xenon O2 come, because in no compound that xenon form fluor 5 oxygen atom. So this is a second acidic, this is third acidic, after that this is a last. So correct option will be A. We have to look at for the more number of fluorine atom, but in this case no 5 fluorine atom is there, so that fifth position is occupied by the oxygen. So third will be fourth, having 4 fluorine atom, and fourth position occupied by the, where third is fluorine with 3 fluorine atoms are not available, so that two position will occupied by the oxygen. So correct option will be A. Now let's see, for oxidation state of sulfur in SO2, consider. So structure is for SO is 2O like this. So in this, what happened? The oxygen will be more electro. See, it will act as -2. It will in a -2 oxidation state. And what do you can think? Generally, sulfur is generally they are also electronegative. So both are considered in -2, -1, which is not correct, because sulfur one of the oxygen is attached to one of the sulfur. So this will be more electropositive. Therefore, it will reside in +4. So due to its electronegative decrease, this sulfur will act as more electronegative. So this will be -2. So correct option will be A. So correct option will be A. And another along with that, so this is a sulfur, this is oxygen. So that double bond will be migrate, or it will become negative charge. And this will be like this. And this will carry a positive charge. So correct option will be having positive charge also, +2 and 0 also. So your correct option will be both A and B. Now let's see magnitude of stability constant for positive potassium plus ion, complexes of supramolecular host follow the order. So this concept based on hard soft acid based concept. So we have to what is order we have to give. So A greater than B or B greater than C, like that the option is given. So we have to look at for that. So according to hard soft base, hard soft acid base, potassium is a hard acids, while oxygen is hard base. So according to this concept, hard acid prefer to bind with hard base. So hardness order will be oxygen is more hard base compared to nitrogen, and nitrogen is hard base compared to sulfur. So sulfur is a generally soft base. So we have to look in the structure which is contain more number of oxygen. From this structure, it contain 5 oxygen, it contain 4 oxygen, and it contain 4 oxygen. But in A option, there is oxygen along with nitrogens are there. So it will more strongly bind to potassium as compared to C, because here hard acid, hard base present, but there are soft bases also present. But in this, along with oxygen, nitrogen is also there. So as compared to sulfur, nitrogen is a comparatively hard base. So here potassium binding will be more. So correct option will be B, because in B more number of oxygen present greater than A, and A is greater than C. The correct option will be BAC, that is option number A. Now let's see next question. Among the compound A2D, which of the hydrolyze easily? So generally, on what happen in hydrolysis reaction, that lone pair of nitrogen will attract the proton, it will form NH plus Cl3, and the further reaction will go take place. So in case of BiCl3 also undergo hydrolysis. Because of the incomplete octet, and PCl3 will also go hydrolysis, availability of d orbital. But in case of NF3, because in nitrogen 3 fluorine are attached to this, because they are electronegative in nature, so this will attract that bonded electron as well as that lone pair of nitrogen. So when they undergo hydrolysis, that lone pair of nitrogen not available to abstract that proton, therefore hydrolysis of that will not occur. So NF3 will be not undergo hydrolysis. So option will be A, C, and D. That is nothing but B. So this is all about P block main group chemistry, previous year questions. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.